Movie of the Week. Presenting the world premiere of an original motion picture produced especially for ABC. Tonight on the Movie of the Week.
It was a Sunday in August. Mom, Dad, David, and I were on vacation digging for fossils in the high Sierras. Mom had to go back to L.A. that morning. We didn't know that 2.5 hours later, the world as we knew it would cease to exist. Bother you?
No. You ready, Barbara?
Yeah. I wish I could stay on.
Yeah, me too. I'll tell you what. Why don't you radio in and let somebody else take care of those guinea pigs for another week, huh?
I wish I could, but you know Oldfield can't handle that
equipment. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, anyway, I've got to get cracking on that paper.
Yes, paper.
I know. I'm not indispensable.
You heard of me.
Not as there's a cave left to explore.
Is that Tom?
Yeah, he's around here somewhere.
Hope he hurries.
Tom! Go, Tom! Well, looks like we've got rabbit stew for dinner again tonight.
Well, doesn't anybody want to come and tell their mother goodbye?
I do. What do you think?
David.
He's still in the cave.
Hey, Pop. Got him going away clean as anything.
Good shot, Tom. Better get your gear together. Miss Anders is ready.
Sorry to get you out of your cave.
Oh.
I forgot to look at my watch.
Oh, you're already picking up my bad habits and you're only 18.
Come on, you're going to miss your flight.
Does anybody want me to call somebody for them? Want me to call your office?
No, don't you dare. That place doesn't exist till this vacation's over. Okay, have a good flight, hon.
Thank you.
Take care of yourself.
I'll see you next week, huh?
Easy on the gas now, Hot Rod. Don't need no broken axle. Say hello to your mama for me.
Bye.
Bye, Mom.
See you later. Okay. Bye, darling.
Bye.
Dad? You think next year we could spend our vacation in some place like, Hawaii or Mexico?
Hey, maybe Mexico. They got some great places to dig down there.
I don't mean digging. I mean like staying at a hotel or swimming in the ocean.
We live on the ocean. What do you want to swim in the ocean for? What kind of vacation is that?
I think what your sister's trying to say is that she'd like a little different kind of vacation.
Yeah. Maybe separate vacations. I'm old enough now.
You're not either. But let's discuss it with your mother when we get home, huh?
Hey.
Come on. Out.
It hit six on the Richter.
Man. Second there, I thought that whole mountain was coming down.
Hey! Everybody all right?
Okay, Clancy.
Boy, that beat anything I ever saw in my life. I guess the Air Force must have tested the biggest bum they ever had.
Bum? You sure that wasn't an earthquake?
No, no. That weren't no natural earthquake. It got real quiet, and the whole sky lit up. Just like the good Lord is snapping a picture.
You serious?
It's the biggest thing I ever seen.
They're not doing any nuclear tests above ground.
No.
I'm telling you, I had to cover my eyes. Did the cave go?
Well, I don't know, but I'm not going back in there to find out. You look funny. Well, we go dust off, huh?
You've been on that thing 3 hours. You going to run them batteries down?
I still can't get anything.
Oh, great. Now I can't even listen to my music.
Never mind the music. Either the government set off a blast or there's been some kind of nuclear accident, and I can't find out what the radio has to say about it.
You two are always so tied up in your caves. Now what are you going to do?
We can do some fishing, play chess, hike. Hey, come here a minute, Deb. Take a look at this. I think we found ourselves a real goodie. It's a Philippite,
Dad?
But it has...
Hey, what is it? I feel weak. It's like I ain't got no energy.
K-9er, X-09er, calling K-9er, X-08, over. K-9er, X-09er. This is K-9er, X-08. Do you read me? Over. All I'm getting is static.
Keep trying.
K-9er, X-09er.
Come on, Mr. Clancy. Good for you. K-9er, X-09er. K-9er, X-09er. No, never mind the food, Deb. Just, try to keep him as comfortable as you can.
K-9er, X-09er. This is K-9er, X-08. I don't understand. The battery seems strong enough.
Maybe Mrs. Clancy went out for a while.
No, it's after 10. She wouldn't leave the receiver for that long. Besides, Tom should have been home hours ago. There must be something wrong with it. Do you think it's an infection of some kind?
I don't know.
Oh.
I don't know, David. You're the physicist. Could radiation poisoning give these symptoms?
Well, I guess, but to happen that fast, it would have to be a massive dose. At least 200 Rankins. Wish Clancy brought his Geiger counter. Then we'd know.
Dad? I think he's getting worse. What are we gonna do?
You better start a mayday on the radio.
What if I can't reach anyone?
We have to get him out of here. In the morning, we'll make some kind of litter and carry him out.
That's a two-day hike.
We don't have any choice, David. Tom isn't due here for a week. We can't sit around and watch him get worse.
Well, does anybody feel like eating?
Yeah, I do.
Good.
No. I don't know whether Clancy is suffering from some sort of radiation sickness or not, but we have to accept that as a possibility. Now, that means this whole area can be affected, and I don't think that we can eat or drink anything unless we had it with us down in the cave.
Dad, we only had one canteen of water in the cave with us. How are we going to survive on that for 2 days?
We'll have to.
Wait a minute.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not much, but it's calories. Get started on the May Day. See if you can find Clancy another blanket, Deb.
This is K-9er X-09er. Mayday, mayday. This is K-9er X-09er. Mayday, mayday.
David. Come on, we're ready to go.
Give me a hand, will you, Deb, please? Take just what you need, David. Less weight, the better. You leave it. We don't need that.
If there's a large dose of radiation, we'll show in the film.
How?
The picture will come out with white spots on it.
Rest here. Gently.
Dad?
No, you. You drink, hon.
I'm all right.
We should have brought another canteen for him.
We only had one canteen in the cave.
He's already suffering from radiation. Drinking radiated water isn't going to do him much harm.
Would have done him a lot more harm than good.
He can have my water.
I didn't mean it that way.
No, I know you didn't. How are your muscles holding out?
Okay.
I think we better keep moving. Ready?
It's gonna be dark soon. We better find a spot to spend the night.
Got an hour or so. Can you hold out?
I'll try.
Put him down.
Nuclear accident is the only thing that makes any sense. Deb?
Debbie?
Oh, sorry, I was thinking of these pictures I saw of Hiroshima.
Now, look, there's no sense in our sitting around frightening each other with speculation. We'll find out what happened when we get back to Rainbow.
What about Clancy? What do we do with him?
We have to take him.
Deb, he's dead. But we got to get out of here as fast as we can.
David, he's a friend. You just can't leave
him. Why should I be the one to feel guilty?
David.
Look, we've been exposed to radiation. Not as bad as Mr. Clancy, but maybe enough to kill us. Now, if we lose time lugging a dead body, maybe we'll all end up that way.
Well, what do you know? 1 year of college physics and you think you know everything. Well, we were in the cave. We were in the cave, Daddy.
That's right, hon. We were, and it probably saved our lives. But I think David is right, and I think we have to get back to civilization as quickly as possible. We'll take care of Clancy. All right. We covered him with rocks. Let's bring him over.
It's flat. The bag's empty.
It can't be. He was dead.
As Clancy's death was, we still believed it was some kind of freak accident. We felt that once we got back to Rainbow, everything would be all right. That all the fears and questions could be answered.
Daddy, there's no one here.
Stay here.
You all right?
Yeah. I'm telling how long it's been closed up in there.
Okay.
Yes, fine. I'm all right now.
What is going on?
Where is everybody?
Well, maybe they had to evacuate the town. They're all at home.
No, people just don't leave their cars in the middle of the street. Where is everybody? Where are all the people?
We'll be inside in electricity. And get out of here before this thing happened.
Wait here.
Tell him to lift his keys.
Hello? Miss Clancy? Tom?
Dad?
They're both dead.
The same way?
Yes.
Well, I checked the blazer. The batteries had it, and the generator's burned out.
Can you fix it?
Well, I can try. Well, wait a minute. It's Clancy's Geiger counter. He showed me how to work it the day we left.
Is it still working?
Well, I think so. Let me see your watch. It's working.
Well, let's check out the food.
Nothing. No radioactivity.
I'll get that. Debbie, we found some food.
Can we eat it?
Yeah, it's okay.
Dad?
Yeah?
I checked all the cars I could find. The generator's gone in all of them. But I found a good battery.
How far can we get without a generator? Batteries wear down.
Well, we only have to carry a couple of them to get home. Oh, thanks.
David, tell me what you think. It wasn't a nuclear blast, was it? I guess you don't have to be a scientist to know that radiation's strong enough to disintegrate human beings. It'll kill everything else, birds, animals, trees, everything. What, bacteria, chemical?
I don't think so. Have to be an energy source of some kind. Knocked out the telephones, electricity, even the car generators.
But batteries work.
Yeah, they're electrochemical. They're self-contained.
Well, then what? A meteor? Some kind of a comet?
I don't know. I don't know what could do it.
Check the oil, Dave. Yeah, I hear the batteries.
Oh, good. Get some oil, too.
Better get some gas. I think we should change batteries while we're here, too.
I have to go to the bathroom.
There's no electricity.
We've only got a quarter of a tank. Maybe we can siphon some from these cars.
I have to go to the bathroom.
All right, I'll take you, honey.
I'll find a siphon.
Thank you.
Yeah, drink.
David, give me a hand.
Hello? What's your name?
What do we do with her?
We clean her up.
No purse, no ID, nothing. Nothing. She said anything?
Not a word. I wish we knew more about her. She wears a wedding ring.
I wish I knew where she was when it happened. Was she underground in some sort of shelter like we were? Well, the important thing is that she's alive. That means there are probably others. Whatever it was that happened, there are survivors.
Hey, gang. Tank's full and the batteries change.
Well, we take her with us.
All right, we better get going. There's only a couple hours of daylight left.
Come on, Ann.
Ann? Is that her name?
We don't know. But she looks like an Ann.
He might be rabid. Go on back there.
Daddy, don't worry.
Drove all day without seeing anyone. None of us wanted to talk about Mom. I guess we were too frightened. But finding Jenny meant that there were survivors. And the hope that Mom made it, just like we did, kept us going through all that lay ahead.
Dad? You think she had a family?
Probably.
I wonder what happened to them. You don't suppose that they all,
Hey, look!
Maybe he could tell us what happened.
Hi. Boy, are we glad to see you. We've been up in the Sierras. We don't know what's going on. What's happened to everybody?
Where are you from?
Well, we were camping up in the Sierras, and then...
Everyone get out of the car. Get out!
Do as he says.
This side. Get away from there. Over here.
Deb?
Quickly, please.
Why are you doing this?
I got a wife and kids in Phoenix. I gotta get to them.
can't just leave us out here without food or water.
Better that than dead.
What's ahead of us?
Nothing.
I wish I'd had the rifle. And then I got the blazer.
Why, would you have shot him?
Yeah.
Have we come to that already, David?
You're going too slow.
She can't walk any faster.
I can't walk any slower.
Well, what do you expect us to do? Leave her here?
What about Mom? How do we know what's happening to her? She may need our help now, and she's slowing us up.
You know, I really believe he'd leave her here. What's happening to him?
He's scared, Ann. I guess this is his way of hiding it. Be patient with him.
No electricity. Bedrooms are empty.
Deb, take her inside, see if you can find something to eat. Let's see if they've got a car, David.
Come on, Anna. There's nothing to be scared of.
No car. Whoever lived here must have taken off. Let's look around here.
They didn't disintegrate.
They got shot. It doesn't look like too long ago either. David? Don't look, but somebody's pointing a gun at us from the barn. No, don't turn. I want you to get back to the house.
Dad.
Just do it. I'll take the corral. That way you'll be out of sight quicker.
I'll go on back to the house.
Debbie, don't come any further. Just go on back to the house.
Dad, who are they?
I don't know. David and I will bury them. Now, please, get back to the house.
She won't go.
David!
You little idiot!
What's happening? Is David all right?
It's all right, Debbie. Go back to the house.
Julie? She thinks my name is Billy.
Well, is it all right if she calls you that just for a little while?
My name is Michael.
Well, just for a little while.
Ago, I was manufacturing plastic cups. Now I'm harnessing horses. Did it right. Sure been a long time. David.
We need it.
Dad! I think she's coming out of it. She looked at me when I touched her and there were tears in her eyes.
Oh, good. That's a good sign. But take her back to the house and pack up. We'll be leaving in a few minutes. I want to talk to Michael.
Okay.
Hey, Michael, check out this harness, will you? See if I did it right.
Yeah, it's fine.
Hey, good. Now, listen, I want to ask you some questions. About what happened. Did you hear about it on the radio? Did your parents tell you about it?
I saw it.
You were out in the open?
Me and my dad. We were baling hay.
Was there a bright flash of light?
Like a bomb?
No, it was the sun. It just got brighter and brighter for a couple of seconds. Then there was the earthquake. We tried listening to the radio, and that didn't work. We tried the telephone and the lights, and that didn't work either. My dad wanted to drive into town, but my mom wouldn't let him. She was scared.
Did your car work?
And these two men came. They were walking. I was in my room. My mom and dad went outside to say hello to them. They talked, and they went toward the garage. My mom and dad were...
Okay, Michael, it's all right. You go help Debbie now, will you? We'll be leaving in a minute. All right, you ready to tell me what's going on? I had a feeling ever since we left Clancy's, you had something on your mind you didn't want to share. Is that for my protection, or yours, or your sister's?
I didn't know for sure.
Come on. David, this is not some scientific experiment where we can sit back and accumulate data to write a paper later on. I'm not a scientist. I have to depend on you. And we have to depend on each other. Now tell me, do you think something happened to the sun?
Yeah, I do.
What?
Probably some kind of explosion.
Would that reduce your mother's chances? Come on, we have to accept the worst.
No!
All right, then. All right, then, let's accept the best. Now, you tell me all you know or all you think you know.
Could have been a solar flare.
Solar flares? Don't they happen all the time?
Yeah, it would have to have been a big one. Bigger than anything ever recorded.
It would send out a tremendous amount of gamma rays, enough energy to knock out the power sources.
But what killed the people? We know it wasn't radiation.
I don't know. It had nothing to do with whether or not they were sheltered.
That's right. Clancy's family died, but Michael and his parents lived. And we're alive, so your mother must be too. All right, let's go tell your sister. Come on, come on.
In the ignition. Of course the key's in the ignition. I am so stupid!
What do you mean?
An electrical overload can only knock out a generator that's working. The ignition has to be on, the engine has to be running. Any other car should be fine.
But you checked other cars in Rainbow.
Only the ones with the key's in the ignition. We must have been running when this thing happened. We wasted all that time with the blazer and the batteries.
Well, at least now we know what to look for. We'll find one. Okay. Get up.
Is she crazy? Something really terrible happened to her. She hasn't told us yet, but she will.
She stares at me.
That's a good sign. That means you interest her.
Easy there, boys. Whoa. Looks like a used car lot.
Any special make, color, model?
Well, David and I look for a car. You can go in the market and get some more food and water, huh? Up, 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 up. Take those.
Dad!
Back away from the car.
Take the car. I've got a family. Don't shoot me.
You were going to shoot me?
No, no. I'm just trying to protect myself. I've already had one car stolen.
So have I.
My name's McFadden. Jack.
Steve Anders.
Can I put my hands down?
Yeah.
That's your family?
Whoa.
Yeah, part of it. My wife's in Malibu.
I came from L.A. Don't go there. I got my wife and kids out. The city's a nightmare. Some people went mad. Like the dogs. Dogs everywhere. Packs of them. I've seen things. My kids have seen things.
What happened? I mean, is it all over the world?
I don't know. The radio went off. There was no communication. I heard something about an epidemic of some kind. I don't know.
Are there many survivors?
You can drive for miles, even in the city, and not find anybody.
Where's your family?
Why?
No, I mean, are they safe?
We found a ranch outside of town. We moved in. We'll stay there. I guess eventually the store food will give out and we'll have to learn how to farm. I'm a cost accountant. I was born and raised in the city. Always dreamed of having a ranch. Now there are plenty of them. We'd be pleased to have you as neighbors.
No, we have to get to the coast. I guess we'll just have to learn to ask questions before we pull the trigger.
Yeah.
Michael, come on down, would you, and bring Ann, please?
Okay.
Let's see if we can find a car.
Just a minute. Check inside the market by the cash register. Some of the employees left their car keys there. It's easier than crossing wires.
Thanks.
Well, good luck.
Good luck. David, take the horses over there and tie them up.
Right. Come on.
Oh, no. Let's have a look.
Whoa, whoa.
We give you a hand?
No, thanks. I'll make it.
Come on, Michael. Help me find some keys. You start there.
Hey, here's some. Look.
Hey, fastest key finder in the West. Good. Good. All right, you help Deb get some food and drinks, will you?
Okay.
Deborah?
Hmm?
Do you think they'll mind if we take the food without paying?
No, I don't think so.
Hmm.
David, we've got our car. We've got a full tank of gas.
We should be home in a few hours.
Get some supplies and pack up the family. Hey, we found a car, Deb. Let's move it along.
Good. Look, Dad, people are leaving messages.
As fast as you can into the store, okay? All right, get by the door and hold it open. All right, Michael, go.
No! Come on, come on!
Did it. Think of them. The dogs.
gently. It'll be all right, Jenny. We're going to take care of you, okay? Los Angeles. Empty and lonely. It was almost as if I could feel and hear all those people, and there was no one there. It was like they were haunting us all the way to Malibu Canyon.
Where are you from, Jenny?
Denver. We were on our way to Disneyland. The kids had never been there. Then my husband got sick. I took him to a hospital in Bakersfield. He was gone so fast. Everybody was dying. The nurses, the doctors, everybody. I tried to get the kids back to Denver, but we ran out of gas. So I had to leave them in the car and try to find another one. I was only gone a few minutes. Then I heard the dogs. And the children were screaming. I ran back. But it was too late.
Are you sure your husband had the same sickness as everyone else?
Yes.
Let's have a look.
I smell fish.
It's the ocean, Michael. It's only a few miles.
The generator's burned out. Blast it.
Well, we're just going to have to walk. David?
Dad!
Don't look! Cover your eyes! Cover!
Hurry!
Hang on, Edwin. Hold it.
Just like the last time.
It was a flare, just like we thought. And the flare set off the quake.
Are we going to die?
Well, no, that can't hurt us.
No, that quake wasn't strong. It must have been some kind of aftershock. I guess if we live through the first one, we'll be all right, huh?
Yeah, good. Get the shotgun and some water. Let's get home as quick as we can.
That you're reading this note. I know there are some people who have survived. It's been 2 days since the solar flare, but already most of the people I know are dead or dying. Within 16 hours, we managed to isolate a virus. Some people, not many, have a built-in resistance, a gene. Probably recessive. I know I don't. Fever has already brought me home to bed. I pray for all of you. I love you and I want you to live. Mom.
I'd rather be dead.
It's almost morning.
Well, she almost made it. One gene. One stupid gene that God gave to me and not to her.
What are we going to do?
I loved her very much. I feel so lost. So all that kept us going was hoping that she was alive. I never thought past this. This is
There is nothing else. Nothing. I said that, Jenny. I was wrong. We're alive, Jenny. There has to be a reason for that. We are very special people because we survived.
No, no.
Jenny.
My husband.
Listen to me.
My children.
Jenny. The ones who died didn't have a choice. We do. We can walk out into that ocean one by one. Or we can gather strength from each other and live.
We knew now we were able to survive. But even more importantly, we wanted to survive. We couldn't stay home because there was no fresh water or land for farming. So 2 days later, we left for Northern California. Ahead of us was a new world. A world waiting for us to begin again.
I can't hold it!
No, 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 you're doing fine. Okay, now just tighten up and reel him in.
Andre, get away!
Oh, you catch another one, there are millions of fish in the sea.
Millions of them.
Hey! Are you guys ready to go?
Bet.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Michael!
Hungry. What kind of soup is that?
Make way for the great American soup.
Can you give me that again?
Up at the Ritz, they pass the word to 42nd Street. Make way for the great American soup. Hey, mister, have you tried the soup that's good enough to eat? Shake hands with the great American soup. Feel that river, guide your feet on the soup. Road to romance. Let's face the chicken, don't go and dance. Who's got it noodled up in life from Broadway to the Loop? It's the great. I said the great. It's the great, great, great American soup.
Emily, why do you always have to make such a big production out of everything?